Hey guys, it's your boy Crippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Fine Art Karima, where last left off. I got that little bit closer, to winning the league. I would have won it in the last episode if I had beaten Ajax back in December. But can't dwell on what could have been and what should have been. All I can do is do what I need to do in this episode to win the league. But first off, I have a game against FC 20 in the Dutch Cup. This is the semi-final, so a win here will see me progress to the final. We'll to face Rode, because he had a look to see if when the other semi-final was, and it had already taken place. Fantastic. So I know who I will be playing in the final should I get past FC 20. As you can see, the second team is out for two, maybe three reasons. One, this is a cup game, and I like to play the second team in the cup games. Two, they've done very well in their past outing, and it's getting me incredible victories, including an over Ajax in a previous round of this competition, as you saw in the previous episode. And three, I need my first team fully fit for the game that follows this, the league game that follows this, because a win or draw in my next league game will be enough to win me the Eredivisie title. And I realize I said it wrong. I don't care. It's better me at least have a go at saying it than saying, oh, the Dutch league.
Well, it is a free kick. They're excited by this. It's a real chance to at least work the goalkeeper.
Oh, it's a free kick. I was wondering what he was doing.
Players in the wall jump.
Oh, yes! The deflection takes it into Traore's path and he buries it. Oh, what a stroke of freaking luck in the opening minutes of this semi-final. It smacks. Ironically, I think it hit the number 10 of. Yeah, it hit the number 10 for FC 20 right in the face. It falls to my number 10, and he buries it in the back of the net. What a stroke of freaking irony that is. My free kick was terrible, as they normally are. Although last night when I was playing in FIFA, I scored another one. Purely by luck. I was playing
Here's the cross. Well, the ball deserved perhaps
playing a game.
Response from his teammates.
He made my
defender got there first.
One of my off screen career modes that I liked it. Just chill. Well, currently I'm doing it with Bradford, I'm trying to get him into the Premier League. It's one of my favorite things to do, is pick a random team from one of the lower leagues in England and bring them up to the Premier League.
Back it goes.
And I took a free kick. I was trying to cross it in. I misjudged the cross in. It bounced. And so I was like, oh crap, that's a terrible penalty. It bounced. The keeper palms it into the net. And I'm like, wait, what? What was that? That was both hilarious, but idiotically stupid. I was like, wait, what? How do you function? So I guess that's two. Lucky free kicks in 24 hours, as it were. Not even 24 hours, that was only a few hours ago. Oh, technically, because I'm recording this in the morning. And if you're wondering why I'm recording in the morning so early, I have to go somewhere later. So I didn't want to... I don't know when I'll be home, so I don't want to leave you guys without your fix of Feyenoord Clermont, especially when this might be, and hopefully will be, the episode where I win the league title. And I should be getting into the final of the Dutch Cup as well.
Gotta cross it.
And I realize the name of it is right up there, but that J is just gonna, yeah, no, that's, that, I'm definitely never gonna be able to pronounce that. Fair play to anyone who can. I'm sure maybe there's Dutch people watching me who are like, oh, that's so easy to pronounce, what are you talking about? I don't know what kind of accent that is. I don't think Dutch people talk like that. I don't really hear a lot of Dutch people.
Love the tackle.
I don't know any Dutch people, unfortunately.
Good that the game's gone ahead.
Because there's periods of my use some of that legal Mary Jane that they sell over there.
Conditions outside are deemed unsafe, then they have no choice, do they?
And I'm not one of those people who would normally do that, but at times you just, you know, you'd be like, what the hell is even going on?
And here's the shot.
Like, I don't know if there's many of you who are fans of wrestling, you know, professional wrestling like WWE, TNA, Ring of Honor, or New Japan, WCPW. But yeah.
And here's the cross. Wonderful goal.
Recently, TNA, if you're not familiar, TNA is a professional wrestling company. But for those of you who are familiar, like TNA, they're still in business? Yeah, they are. Surprisingly. I know. Oh, somehow they are still in business. They put on what had to been the most crazy bullshit I've ever seen in my life. And, it's just one of those things where you're like, I don't know if I could even enjoy this if I was high off my nuts. So, you know, it's just one of those things. You're just like, what am I watching? If you've no idea what I'm talking about, and either you're a professional wrestling fan and you're a lucky one and you've not seen what I'm talking about, the Final Deletion is what it's called. Don't look it up if you've never heard of it. You have heard about it and not seen it. You're not missing anything except the most crazy few minutes of your life, which you'll never get back, so don't waste them. Yeah. Basically, it's TNA's last stand. They're gonna they can pave over the cracks as much as they want. If that video doesn't say TNA is dying and will not see out 2016. I don't know what it says, because it reeks of just sad, depressing thing. I mean,
back it goes to the keeper. Gutierrez.
As any professional wrestling fans might know what I'm talking about. They could have been a good company at one point, but you know, they've had a few decent matches. You know, one match is absolutely unbelievable. Whole triple threat between Samoa Joe, who WWE fans who never watched TNA will recognize as the current NXT champion. AJ Styles, who is currently in a feud with
strong tackle on the ball. John Cena, he was there as well. He was in that match as well. And Christopher Daniels, who, if you never watched TNA, or just are only a WWE fan, you probably don't even know.
These two, as they jostle for possession. He's going to try it. Into the challenge, he made the block.
Because he's mainly indie, I don't think he's ever been in WWE. I cannot confirm nor deny that.
They got it back via an interception.
But, yeah, probably their best match in history, and it happened 3 years after their, pretty much in their third year of existence, and they've had, you know, only average matches since, and a lot of crap. And like I said, if what I saw wasn't a scream for help from TNA,
make a substitution now.
Basically, they don't have that many big stars left, because pretty much all their big stars are now in WWE, quite literally. I mean, Samoa Joe, AJ Styles, Austin Aries, he was there as well. Well, Bobby Roode, another one, and NXT fans, if you remember, or James Storm when he came over for a few outings in an NXT ring. Yeah, he's a TNA star. He went back there, but I don't think he'll be staying.
The team in this situation, they're encouraged by the lead, but they're fearful perhaps that this team might lose it.
Well, they won't want to give anything silly away. The opposition are chasing the ball, trying to get.
It's quite simply, it is definitely a cry for help. I think TNA is gonna go out of business. And as a wrestling fan, you know, you don't really want to say that. You don't want a company to go out of business because, you know, that's people's livelihood. That's just being, you know, taken away from them. But
4 minutes left.
TNA is having financial trouble, and they can say they're not, but they are. It was pretty much confirmed. If any of you know the band Smashing Pumpkins, their like lead singer had to buy TNA stock so that they could even have their Slammiversary pay-per-view last month.
He could have found the target there.
Well, this could be their last chance to salvage something from this match. Well, that was looking good, and now it's turned over, and all the potential.
So yeah, they can say they're not having financial trouble, but they are. They are 100% having financial trouble, and I don't want them to go under, but, well, I don't really know. The fact that they subjected me to the horrific confusion of having to watch that Final Deletion match, and the fact that they're trying to ruin the careers of two characters who, when I was young, were my favorites, and I know that a lot of people's favorites. It's, if you don't know anything about TNA, the Final Deletion match was between Matt and Jeff Hardy. Yes, the Hardy Boys. He's participated in this crap. I mean, WWE had a stupid feud between them. In fact, they had a few stupid feuds between the Hardy Boys. But that Final Deletion match may as well have made those matches 5-star classics. It was shit. And there are some people out there who liked it. I don't know why. I think they're just trying to troll us all by being utterly brain dead. No. Oops. Didn't switch the teams. But yeah. If you've not seen it, don't worry. And as for TNA's status, like I said, they can pave over the cracks if they want, but the writing is on the wall. They're going out of business. They can't paper over that crack forever. That crack is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger until the wall fucking breaks. And I can't see the wall proverbial TNA wall surviving 2016. It just can't. I don't care how much Smashing Pumpkins money they have of being injected into the company now. It's not going to be enough. Especially if they're... I mean, if that doesn't cost them whatever viewers they might have left. TNA fans are quite simply brain dead and shouldn't be allowed to breed for the good of the planet.
Yeah, I mean, it can be adjusted. It could almost be a 4-5-1 if they decide to come over all defensive, this team. But if they're on the
field, I know there's a lot of football fans who don't watch wrestling and are like, what are you talking about? Can you talk about all the matches you're playing? Like, you completely ignored your win over FC 20. It's getting one passing mention. And you're right, I'm sorry, I should be focusing on what I'm doing. Well, I am focusing on what I'm doing, it's just... Don't really have another topic to talk about. I talked how at length in the last episode about...
How the game changes.
Both the,
And there's the shot.
Biv... history I'll be making when I win the Eredivisie with Feyenoord, because it'll be the first time that they've won it since the 1998-1999 season. So a 17-year wait is about to come to an end.
Will peter out that attack. It's the goalkeeper's ball quite easily.
Of course, there's 90 minutes of football between now and then. Well,
offside, it's an easy
15 minutes are gone, so not a full 90 minutes right now. Oh, but it was at the start of this match.
Here comes the cross. Cut off! But he's had a go.
Really, Mark? Really? Question is right now, who will be today's hero? Who is going to bang in the goals that will carry Feyenoord to something that their fan base have been waiting 17 years
for?
Out. Dirk Kuyt in off the post. It's Dirk Kuyt in what is his last year as a professional footballer, because he's retiring at the end of the season. He's gonna go out in a blaze of glory.
Teammate there was actually getting ready to knock in the rebound, but it's gone in and it's a good goal. Well, it's a goal worth replaying.
His form has been really good in the last couple of games. And has Kuyt scored a good few goals in the last episode as well. He's got now 14 for the season. Of course, that's still nowhere near Stendeta and Kramer, who both have 20 plus goals. But, he's still turning the table. We're going to finish turning the table until unless he bangs in a shit ton of goals between now and the end of the season.
Larsen. Onto the attack now.
Great challenge by Ivan Beck. Prevent any opportunities of attack from
this could be
them too,
Alan, because obviously the team that are visiting today
still don't understand their name.
Reverse match, so they've got a little bit of a psychological edge, but of course they're
a fair way away from home.
Yeah, they are.
You think I'd look it up, but nah.
Taking the chance with the shot.
That is a great block, though, from their defender. But yeah, he can see the corner. Doing so, Kramer over the bar. Brilliant. Brilliant stuff there, Kramer. Elia.
It's very good skill. He's made the defender look a bit awkward there.
Loop it in. Header. Oh, it's a post. What the? What? That was the opportunity for a second goal just before the half. I might get another opportunity. But that fucking sucked.
Goalkeeper at full stretch.
Oh, the keeper saved and they're going to get away and the opportunity is gone.
Well, that's halftime.
Oh, hey, he blew the halftime whistle before her booking my player. Fantastic. 45 minutes away. Hey, 45 minutes. And the
second period.
Eredivisie title is officially mine. I won't get it now because, you know, of course I have to wait until the last game of the season. Yeah.
Knocked away long.
Bahana. Ooh, I thought the deflection might make it hard for the keeper, but it made it more easy for him. It might have been harder for him if it hadn't taken the deflection. Frank.
Brilliant team play with the passing, the movement off the ball to make the passing possible.
And get out of the ball. Go. Go, Mark.
This could be it.
Stenda. Clear through on goal. Can he make it 2-0? He hits it straight at the keeper and then runs into him. Where's the logic? Kramer. Wins the ball back. Vahana. Lovely 1-2. It's come back to Kramer. He whips it in. Elia. Oh my god. It at least won a corner, but what the fuck was that?
It is corner.
Oh, and the header is way over the bar. Oh no, it's another corner, actually. Never mind. Alamedi goes for it off the crossbar. The woodwork is being like a second in opposition today. Hey, hitting the post in the first half and hitting the crossbar here in the second. What is going on?
To his teammate for a moment.
So yeah, it's just gonna be a yellow card. Yeah.
It's a yellow card.
Yeah, I don't think.
Knew as soon as I. He pressed the square button, but I couldn't risk them getting perhaps through on goal and maybe getting the shot away. Can't be too difficult taking one for the team.
It's a real tussle between the two of them.
Kramer.
Try and get the ball.
It's taken out.
A strong tackle between them. Actually, the ball's gone out.
All the referee gives is a throw.
Numel.
Oh, the defender does his job.
The debate will be raging here, Alan, but not anymore.
I like it's trying to tell me that wasn't over the line, even though it was pretty obvious. It wasn't over the line.
Well, they're still battling to try and get
there. Oh yeah.
Search for supremacy successful. Possession facts suggest that.
You've voiced the challenge. Kramer 2-0. Oh. The title is wrapped up. 17 years. His wait is over. or Feyenoord fans, you are welcome. Enjoy it.
The ability to use the neck muscles like that. Great header.
And Kramer with glancing at her. Boom.
Very well taken.
Simple as can be. Especially for the man who was terrible at the start of the season. I signed a player to perhaps replace him. And all of a sudden he has 25 goals. And has secured the Eredivisie title for Feyenoord. Funny how that works out, isn't it?
It's time for the substitutes, I think, and the substitution for the home team here.
Oh, Kramer's won the ball. Oh, will he add a third? Oh, he's at the post again! What the hell is going on? Why? Why does the woodwork hate me today? And then the keeper pulls off an amazing follow-up save. And another great save from the header from Kramer. Or corner on the other side. He'd count. And that's going to be a goal kick.
Oh, that's a poor shot. I think he's just...
Not long to go. Willem, two will have to pull three goals out of their backside really quickly if they're going to prevent the crowning of new champions. And again, I could still win in the league even if I lost. Which I'm not gonna do now. Kaut is absolutely sure heard it. He's stuck in the freaking goal and everything. He gets a nerve assist. He crosses it in. It was practically in the net when Kaut headers it anyway. And he couldn't bend much closer, could he? And then you get stuck in the goal hole for 15 goals this season, 2 in this match. Dirk Kuyt, in his last season as a professional footballer, is guaranteed he's going to go out as a league champion. Hopefully I can grab him in the cup to go with that as well. It was my mini goal to at least win the cup, but I've won the league as well. As soon as the referee blows the whistle to confirm it. Here's Kramer. Can he add another? Oh, a fantastic save from the keeper. Kuyt.
It's the wrong side of the post, but only just.
It's wide of the mark. The goal kick should be the last kick of the game. No? There it is! It's confirmed! Look at the players, they are ecstatic, they know exactly what that means. Scarius looks like he has a broken nose. Not sure how that happened. Again, the players aren't really, they're not exactly, yay, we won the league. The substitutes were more excited about it than the starting 11. They're not exactly celebrating. We won the league. So what? They're acting like they win the league every fucking week or some shit. I was mentioning that I could have won the league even if I had lost because PSV were playing. They won. But, like I said, that's not going to matter. It should say, there it is. Feyenoord win Eredivisie title. Three and four. 7 games remaining. I have a gap of 23 points. Which is 2 more than the 21 that PSV can get in their last few games. So, it is done. Feyenoord's 17-year wait for a league title has been ended by yours truly. Because, it's what I do. was there any doubt? No, there wasn't really. There's not one of you that's surprised, unless you're new to the channel. In which case, welcome! This is what I do. I win the league. And again, I win all the trophies. Yeah. So, you're probably sitting there thinking to yourself, now what? Well, chances are, I'm going to go through these next few games off camera. As you can see, there's only a few games left. Oh, crap. Oh, that sucks. I can only get to the, wow, look at that. Back-to-back Sunday games against the same team. One in the league and one in the cup. Why didn't they put the cup down here somewhere? Or in May? Hey, why is it 2 weeks before the end of the season? Man. Freaking idiots. I'm probably going to sim those games. And in the next episode, you will see the final of the Dutch Cup against Roda JC. And the final league game against Glorijen, where I will pick up the Eredivisie title. So, it's more than likely that the next episode will be the final one of this career mode. But don't fret, I have more career modes because... As after this is a trip to Marseille. Hey, for a bit. In France, you know? So, until next time, thanks for watching. Oh, enjoy. Smash the like button from me officially winning in the Eredivisie title. Oh, and don't forget to come back in the next episode where I. We will hopefully complete the double, and I'll pick up the Eredivisie title officially. Until then, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace!